Hello students, today we are going to start our new chapter from the supplementary reader of English Test Book Class 8, and the chapter name is How the Camel Got His Hump, written by Rudyard Kipling. Before we proceed, let us try to know in the beginning of the world how man tamed, that is domesticated, animals, and which animals helped him in his work. There are time when the world started, when there is no machine was there, people were making use of animals for making their work easily to be done. So here is a story which goes like this, which we are going to do in this lesson, the how the camel got his hump. Before we move on to the story, let us know something about the author. Rudyard Kipling was born on December 30, 1865 in Bombay, India. He was educated in England but returned to India in 1882. In 1892, Kipling married Caroline Bales Dyer and settled in Brattleboro, Vermont, where he wrote The Jungle Book 1894 and Gunga Din, eventually becoming the highest paid writer in the world. Kipling was recipient of the Nobel Prize for Literature in 1907 and he died in the year 1936. Let us know the characters in this story. The first, the camel. The camel is an animal who is so lazy, not doing any work in the story. The horse carries load on his back. This work is given to him by the man. The dog does the work of taking the stick in his mouth. The ox do the work of ploughing in the field. The man guide the animals in the work given by him. And the last, the jinn, who is in charge of all the desert. So these are some of the characters in the story. Let us move on to the story, how the camel got his hump. In this story, there are two parts. The first part we are going to see, in which the animals are working for humans, and how in that one animal is not doing anything, and what has been made to that, and how he has been given something so that the other animals are suffered because of that. Let us have something about that in this story. The world had just begun and the animals were working for humans. So in this part, we are going to see about that when the world had just begun. That is, the author is telling that when the world had started its beginning, that time no machines, no vehicles was there for carrying anything or doing the work of humans. Before that, the humans are taking the help of the animals for carrying a heavy loads or anything, and they to move from one place to animal. Animals are used to carry them from one place to another. Such animals are there in the story. There was one lazy animal that did nothing and said nothing but hum. So there was one lazy animal in that so many animals, that animal was doing nothing, just he is saying hump and hum and just repeating that word whenever anybody is asking to him anything. Even the clever jinn was at his wit's end. So in the end, the jinn, who is the character who has supernatural power, who can change anything like supernaturally, so he also become very tired of the camel, that he made something, the camel, that made the camel to suffer through his lifetime. Let us move on to the text now. In the beginning, when the world was new and the animals were just beginning to work for man, there was a camel, and he lived in the middle of a howling desert because he did not want to work. He ate sticks and thorns and prickles, and when anybody spoke to him, he said hump, just hump and no more. So in these lines we can see that the author is saying, in the beginning when the world was very new, there are so many animals that were just made for human being, like they are started to work for human being in such a way that they are helpful for them in so many things. There was a camel, and he lived in the middle of a howling desert. It was very desert, that there is very dry enough, we can say, because he did not want to work. In the desert, there will be no water, nothing, and the camel is going and sitting over there so that nobody will call him to work. So he's going and sitting over there and just wasting the time doing nothing. So only what he was eating is, he ate sticks and thorns. You can see that in the desert area, no leaves and such things are available. Only the thorns. Thorns, which means we can say that the prickly, the we can say that the leaves which will be very harsh and it will be very dry. And the prickles is also having like prickles and thorns, both which are available in the desert areas. We can see which is very dry like a stick, that the camel is eating over there, and if anybody is going and speaking to the camel, is just saying hump, just hump, nothing more he was saying at that time. Presently, the horse is one of the characters in the story. He is going on the Monday when the work was started, came to him on Monday morning. That is, he is going to meet camel on the Monday morning with a saddle on his back, and said, saddle a load on his back, and said, camel, oh camel, come out and trot like the rest of us. Trot, do the work like us. Rest of us all are doing the work. Why you are sitting over here? Come, let us do the work like rest of the animals. For that, what the camel is saying, see, hump, said the camel, as it is the only word said by the camel, hump, and the horse went away and told the man. As the man is giving the work to the animals, the horse told the man about that. When he called camel, the camel is not coming to work. Now, next, who is going? Let us see. Presently, the dog came to him with a stick in his mouth and said, camel, oh camel, come and fetch and carry like the rest of us. Hump, said the camel, and the dog went away and told the man. Next, the dog is going to the camel, and it is Tuesday. The dog is going to the camel and saying that, come on. He is calling the camel, come on, fetch, take the stick and do the work like us, because the work of dog is to carry the stick. So he is calling the camel to do the work like rest of the animals are also doing some of the other work. For that also, camel said the same word, hum. And after that, the dog also went away and told about that incident to the man. So this is about the first page of the lesson in your textbook. When you read, you can understand by your own. Presently, the ox came to him with the yoke on his neck and said, "Camel, O camel, come and plow like the rest of us." "Hump," said the camel, and the ox went away and told the man. So here it's on Wednesday. The ox, next animal who is going to meet the camel is ox. He is going to the camel and saying that, "O camel, come and plow." Plow means the field work. Plowing of, we can say that the animals are tied and in the soil it will be digged through the ox. Like the rest of us. Like he is saying that the rest, all other animals are working. So you also come and work like us. For that also the camel is giving the same reply, that is hump. And the ox went away and told the man. The ox also went away like the other animals, and they also told about that incident, how the camel is replying when they are calling to work. The camel is not saying anything and not coming for the work, just saying hump and just sitting over there in the middle of the desert. At the end of the day, the man called the horse, the dog and the ox together and said, "303, I am very sorry for you, but that hump thing in the desert can't work or he would have been here by now. So I am going to leave him alone and you must work double time to make up for it." Now the man is calling all the three animals, that is the horse, the dog and the ox, to discuss about this matter, what the camel is doing on the desert. For that the man is saying that if the camel is saying hump and hump and not coming for the work, we have to have some solution for it. And I got a solution, is that we will leave that hump matter over there only. Let him stay there only. But one thing you have to do is you have to do the work of that camel to by yourself. That means they have to do the double of their work now. So that made the three very angry, and they held a panchayat on the edge of the desert, and the camel came chewing curd and laughed at them. Laughed at them. Then he said hump and went away. So here see that what happened. All the three animals started to be angry with the camel now. So they started to held over a meeting about among themselves on the edge of the desert, where camel came chewing the cud, whatever he was having inside the mouth, the grass and the sticks which he was having. He laughed at the three. So how it will be? He is not doing any work. When the work is given to the other animals, when we laugh at them, how it will feel to the other animals? Then he said hump and went away. So when the three animals held a meeting over there in the edge of the desert, making one of the three animals, the camel, came chewing a cud, which means a grassy, which the sticks and the prickles which was eating by the camel. He started to laugh at them. The camel laughed at the three animals and then he said the same thing, hump and went away, which made the other three animals even more angry. Let us move on to the next paragraph of the story in the next video of this lesson.